podcast. Estamos acá en La Isla Magazine y www.latinxtoday.com. Hoy nos acompaña Kurbet Langley. That's I'm pronouncing right?
Yes, that was right.
That okay, was welcome.
Thank you.
To La Isla Magazine and to latinxtoday.com, that is our news portal.
Awesome.
So we want to tell all the people about the Red Cross. Okay, así que hoy vamos a hablar de un tema muy importante que es ¿qué es la Cruz Roja? Que es una entidad muy interesante que está, nosotros siempre la hemos visto alrededor del mundo, pero hoy Culver nos va a contar de qué se trata, qué es importante que conozcamos nosotros acá en el Low Country y cuáles son los servicios que nos presta y a sí mismo algunas oportunidades que tenemos que saber frente a la Cruz Roja. So, welcome Culver.
Thank you.
What is the Red Cross?
The Red Cross is there to prevent and alleviate human suffering in the face of emergencies. We couldn't do that without the power of our volunteers and the generosity of our donors. So you will see us out there after a home fire. We'll provide financial assistance to people who need it after a fire. Of course, we're involved with hurricanes, opening shelters for those. We're collecting life-saving blood. We work with members of our military. And we also were there to teach life-saving courses as well, like CPR and AED training.
A lot of things.
A lot of things, very involved.
Big organization. Yes. Bueno, Culver nos cuenta que efectivamente es una organización bastante grande que se hace afortunadamente por sus voluntarios, por las personas que donan, trabajan de manera conjunta con los militares y tienen muchos servicios entre cursos y muchos aprendizajes, sobre todo para emergencias que la población necesita saber. So, what are the services that you provide?
Certainly. It obviously depends on the type of a disaster, but the disasters we respond to mostly in South Carolina are home fires. We respond to an average of 6 home fires throughout the state every day. So our volunteers will go out there and they'll provide financial assistance for people to get the things that they need immediately, like clothing or food. In some cases, we'll provide financial assistance for a place for them to stay. And then our caseworkers will actually work with them through that recovery process. And the most important thing to know is that we provide services to everyone who will need it. And then also during hurricanes, we'll open up shelters for people. We will be out in the communities handing out hot meals in the days and weeks after the storm. And also those much needed cleanup kits with mops and brooms and things that people may need. So our services are really dependent upon the specific disaster we're responding to.
Perfecto, pues la Cruz Roja está muy preparada para temas de desastres. Normalmente, pues en estas costas vemos mucho los huracanes, razón por la cual están listos para ayudar a las personas que pierdan hogares, sean desastres naturales, incendios, cualquier otro tipo de situación de emergencia que se pueda presentar. Pueden ayudarlos con asistencia financiera, con asistencia por parte de voluntarios. Igualmente, pueden apoyarnos, por ejemplo, a las familias que en algún momento han sido afectadas por alguna situación de estas. Hay un acompañamiento permanente de la Cruz Roja.
And there, one of the, like, the, we heard about that you have some courses that people can take. What you can tell us about?
Sure, we offer CPR and AED courses. These are life-saving courses that will prepare people to help them know what to do in the event that somebody is having a heart attack. We can also offer babysitting classes as well. So if somebody wants to learn how to be a registered babysitter with the Red Cross, they can go to redcross.org and type in their zip code and find the courses nearest them. And those are really important because that's empowering the community, teaching them the skills that they need to potentially save a life.
Very, very interesting.
Yeah.
Bueno, pues Culver nos cuenta que la Cruz Roja ofrece los cursos de primeros auxilios y los cursos de CPR, que es básicamente para que las personas sepan cómo reaccionar en una situación de emergencia, como devolverle la vida a una persona. Por ejemplo, el CPR hace referencia a un ataque del corazón, entonces cómo poder reanimar a esa persona. Adicionalmente hablábamos del cuidado de niños, entonces también pueden desarrollar un curso de cuidado de niños. Pueden ustedes ir a
www.redcross.org,
así que sería www.redcross.org, and they can put the zip code, right?
Correct, yes, yeah, that's right, the zip code.
That's right, así que ustedes pueden colocar su zip code, el número de código postal, y con el código postal les aparecerán en su área qué cursos pueden ustedes tomar con la Cruz Roja para estar alertas ante cualquier tipo de emergencia. Also,
what do the people need to know about in when we have any emergency?
Mm-hmm.
Why is it important?
The best thing people can do right now to prepare for emergencies is download the Red Cross Emergency app on their cell phones. It can be, there's a Spanish version as well. You can make that the main language there so people can know what they need to have in their emergency kits so that they can prepare for whatever storms may come their way. Hurricane season is a couple of months out, but it's really important that people start getting those important documents that are in their home insurance policies, any sort of social security cards, any of those kinds of things, put those all together so that people have them in the event that they need them. And they also want to start thinking about what to do with their pets in the event that a disaster happens as well. So the best thing that people can do right now is download that Red Cross emergency app and start preparing for whatever disasters may come their way.
Wonderful. So that's very important because now the technology, so that people can...
Right.
Okay, so what Culver, lo que nos está contando Culver es que una de las cosas más importantes que necesitamos saber es que ustedes vayan y descarguen la aplicación de la Cruz Roja, la tengan en su celular, hay una versión en español y ustedes pueden ahí tener paso a paso qué hacer en una situación de emergencia. Ya se aproxima el tema de los huracanes, siempre debemos prever cualquier situación que se presente. En nuestras casas, por ejemplo, prevenir siempre cualquier tipo de situación de incendios. Entonces, hoy la Cruz Roja está a la altura de la tecnología. You have a lot of things with the technology.
Yeah.
Y eso nos permite tener hoy esa aplicación en nuestros teléfonos para que sepamos eso. Bueno, sometimes people are like kind of scared, mm-hmm. or they don't know how to, when we have like a hurricane, and they don't know where to go, or mm-hmm. or we have the shelters, but
right.
Do they need any requirements, or how that works?
That's a great question. People can use the Red Cross Emergency app and find the shelters that are closest to them. The best thing and the most important thing that we want to say is that everyone is welcome at a Red Cross shelter. We don't require ID, we don't do background checks on the folks who come into our shelters. We ask them to list their name, and if we start working with them, if their homes are damaged by the storm, we ask them to kind of confirm that they do live in that home, but they can do so by a utility bill or something like that. So the most important thing for people to know is that any and everyone is welcome in a Red Cross shelter. We make sure that we are creating and inviting space for anybody, regardless of their citizenship, regardless of their background. It doesn't matter, anyone is welcome.
Oh, wonderful. That's something very important.
Mm-hmm.
And bueno, lo que nos dice Culver es que en un momento de una emergencia existen los shelters que ofrece la Cruz Roja, donde apoyan los voluntarios y están todos. No se necesita ningún tipo de documento, no se va a hacer ninguna verificación, por ejemplo, de background check, normalmente, como se denomina, que es una verificación de antecedentes. En un momento de emergencia se necesita apoyar a la comunidad y no importa quién necesita la emergencia, puede ir, presentarse. La Cruz Roja, allí están todos bienvenidos en una situación de emergencia, que eso es algo fundamental para que todos lo conozcamos y lo sepamos.
Maybe there's something else that the people need to know?
I think now, again, it's just the time to start preparing. Make sure that you know, thinking about if you have to leave because of a hurricane and you've got family somewhere, start thinking about where you may go if you need to escape from a hurricane. Also know your evacuation zone. That's really important, especially down here closer to the water. The Emergency Management Office of South Carolina has evacuation zones that are set up for people. And also just know that the Red Cross is there. We are there in South Carolina communities every day, whether it's responding to a home fire or helping a military member or their family. The Red Cross is going to be there for South Carolina.
Bueno, pues se acercan los momentos de huracanes o cualquier situación y nos comenta Culver que la Cruz Roja siempre está ahí, pendiente para todas las personas. Ustedes deben saber que pueden en un determinado momento asistir a estos shelters, tomar los cursos, descargar la aplicación en su celular, estar siempre muy atentos y saber que todo este tipo de beneficios y servicios de la Cruz Roja están para la comunidad, están para ustedes y allí está presente la Cruz Roja. Well, so Culver, thank you so much
thank
for all
you.
The information.
Appreciate it.
And we are very glad to have you here in La Isla Magazine
thank
and LatinXToday.com.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Yeah.
Thank you so much.